अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह अल्हम्दुलिल्लाहि वस्सलातु वस्सलामु अला रसूलिल्लाहि अम्मा बाद आऊज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश शैतानिर रजीम बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। सो इंशाल्लाह वी विल कंप्लीट आवर एनालिसिस ऑफ द टेक्स्ट ऑफ सलाह। सो इन केस इफ एनीवन ऑफ यू हु आर ऑलरेडी इन द मीटिंग, इफ यू वांट टू आस्क एनीथिंग रिगार्डिंग व्हाट हैज बीन डन सो फार, प्लीज डोंट हेजिटेट इंशाल्लाह, एंड यू आर मोर देन वेलकम टू आस्क एनी ऑफ योर क्वेश्चंस। Okay, now as we all know that they are different duas, because different people they recite different duas after salawat ibrahimiya. So inshallah let's cover one of those duas, and as we know that this is the most common one, and this is actually part of surah ibrahim. So in that surah, this is towards the end of that surah, it is the dua of ibrahim alayhis salam. And because as we know that most of the people they normally recite this dua, so inshallah let's analyze this one, and then in future inshallah if you want we can analyze some other duas as well. So let's begin. So rabbi, this first word rabbi, this word rabbi, we have discussed this in the past as well, that you know, like sometime we have the word Rabbana, sometime we have the word Rabbi. So let me tell you this one thing first. In the case of, for example, Rabbana, whenever it comes in the Quran as Rabbana, there's a implied ya harfun nida, which is implied, and then Rabbana. And we know that because Rabba and Na is a mudaf mudaf ilay construction. And whenever munada, munada means the one being called. Whenever munada is a mudaf mudaf ilay, in that case, munada goes into nasab status. So this Rabbana, for example, is actually ya Rabbana. Because of ya, the first word Rabbu has become Rabba. That is one thing. Now in this dua, this word Rabbi, first thing is same. That there is a implied ya in the start. So there is a ya, and whatever this Rabbi is, it is actually becoming munada. Ya is harfun nida, and that is implied here, and then Rabbi is munada. Now the second point is that if this is the case, then it should be, as I discussed before, that if your munada is mudaf mudaf ilay, even in that case, it should be Rabba and Yi. Now, let me tell you this thing, and this was one of the question of Brother Tafazzul as well, that whenever this Ya, this Mutakallim, this first person attached pronoun Ya, this Ya is attached, it doesn't matter either Haraka is Dhamma or Fatha or Kasra, that Haraka becomes employed. For example, in this first word is actually ya rabbayi, ya rabbayi. In this case, that ye has been actually you can say made employed as well. Let me show you that how in the books of Arab they explain this point. Let me show you one thing. This is that same surah, let me make it a bit bigger, and in this ayah it comes wa iz qala ibrahimu rabbi ja'al, the same thing. In that one it is rabbi ja'alni, in this one it is rabbi ja'al, but rabbi part is same. So look at this one, rab munada. So this rab is munada bi harfi nidai, harf nida is also there, mahzuf, it is mahzuf mean employed, that this rab is munada. And before this one, harfun nida, ya, is employed. Wal aslu, and in reality, ya rab. This is the actual word, ya rab. Wa huwa mansub, alamatu nasbihi. It says that the alama or the sign of its nasab, fathatun, there should be the fatha muqaddiratun. It is muqaddira means that it is estimated. It is, you cannot see that. Okay, it has been made, you can say, hidden, which means that, like I said before, it is ya rabbayi. Okay, ya rabba. This one was rabba. Okay, but it says that fatha is muqaddiratun. Okay, ala ma qabliya al mutakallim al mahzufa. It says that with this one, there's a ya, okay, and that ya is also mahzuf. Where it is it? Ma qabl. Before, after this one, there's a ya, and before the ya, there's a fatha. One more time. After rab, there's a ya, and before the ya, there's a fatha which you cannot see anymore. Why? Ikhtisaran wa iktifaan. To make it shorten and just to make it sufficient. Which means that by giving the kasra dalatun alaiha, it says that this rabbi is given this kasra, and the last kasra on the rabbi is actually indicating the ya, attached ya. Okay, one more time. Ya al-mutakallim al-mahzufa. Ya of first person is al-mahzufa. So it is implied. Why? Ikhtisaran wa iktifan bi kasrati. It says that the kasra on the rabbi dalatun alaiha. It basically is it is pointing to that. Wal ya al-mahzufa. And it says that the ya which is implied, damir muttasil, it is an attached pronoun, fi mahalli jar, it is in the place of jar, bil idafa, because it is idafa. So in a nutshell, this is actually rabbi, ya rabbi. Okay, sometime what we are learning today is that sometime ya rabbi is simply made rabbi. That last kasra is actually the indication that there's a ya also at the end. So this is how they explained this whole thing. I just wanted to show you that how they have explained in the books of Arab. Now let me go back.
Ustaz, one question. Yes. What did these two words mean? Iktisaran wa iktifaan.
They said that it was ya rabbayi. Okay. They say that the fatha of rabba has been made hidden, muqaddiratun, and then the ya, the last ya is also had been made implied. Why? Ikhtisaran, to make it short, wa ikhtifaan, and it has been made sufficient bi kasratin, by giving the kasra to Rabbi.
Okay. So it has been shortened, and yes, it is also sufficient to show by the kasra.
Exactly.
Got it. Okay. So basically, with the kasra, yeah, it is implying two things: the ya, yeah, and also the end, the beginning, and also ya at the end.
No, brother. The ya, the kasra of this ba, Rabbi Jaal, the kasra of the ba is actually indicating that there is a ya of first person attached, and that ya has been removed. Instead of that ya, ba is given kasra.
Right.
And what was the...
Sometimes we also see kasra with the ba and also ya.
Yes. You are
so
right.
What is the difference, and when do I understand when it is there sometimes and it's not there sometimes?
Okay. Akhi, in a simple terms, Akhi, Abdul Bari, the thing is that if you say simple Rabbi and there's no harf jar before Rabbi, it will be indication that it is actually Rabbayi.
Right.
So basically, brother, Rabbi and simple word Rabbi, they are actually, both of them are same. In the case of Rabbi, they have removed the last ya by giving the kasra, and in the case of Rabbi, they did not remove the ya.
Right.
But okay. In both cases, it is Rabbayi.
In both cases, Rabbayi. Okay.
So basically, what we have seen there If you see, for example, let me write it here as well, so we can be further clear. I write down it here. For example, what I was saying is, that Rabba plus ye. You will find this one in the Quran in two forms. Sometime in this form, Rabbi, and sometime in this form, Rabbi. But both of them are actually Rabbayi. And in all of these cases, Ya is employed. And this is the Ya which has given this Fatha. Brother, make sense?
It does. I know the reasons, but what I don't understand is why it would be shown then differently. Why in one place with the Rabbi, another place is Rabbi?
For example, look at this one. Abdul Bari, one of the reasons when we see things are made shortened is that it becomes heavy on the tongue. For example, if it was Rabbi, then Rabbi yaj'alni. It was heavy on the tongue. So that's why Rabbi yaj'alni, it has been made light for the tongue.
Right, okay.
So this is one of the main reasons when something is removed or made short to make it light on the tongue.
Right, okay.
For example, you can try this one. If this was Rabbi, then it was Rabbi yaj'alni, and now it is Rabbi jalni. So Rabbi jalni is more smoother on the tongue as compared to Rabbi yaj'alni.
Yeah, okay.
So this can be one explanation.
Mm-hmm.
Inshallah, brother, clear this one?
Yeah, this one.
Okay, so now let me erase this one so we can go back to the analysis. So we have done with the first part, that is first part, Rabbi is basically Munada. Munada, and Ya is employed. Okay, Ya in the start here is employed. And we have said this thing multiple times, that Harfun Nida and Munada, we only analyze them, we don't make them part of the Jumla. Jumla is starting from next one. So Rabbi Aj'alni. So this thing, Aj'al and Ni, they are two words. Okay. So now this first one is Fail Amr. Yaj'alu has become Aj'al. Okay. Yaj'alu. Taj'alu, if you make the whole chart of Mudare, so Taj'alu, you remove the Ta, and then you give a Hamza, so Aj'al. So the actual word is Aj'al, and Aj'al is Fail Amr. It has a built-in file, and that is Anta. And then this Ni is an attached pronoun, and we know that whenever pronoun is attached with the Fail, it plays the role of Maf'ul. So, aj'alni, you make me, because ja'ala means to make something. You make me. We have discussed multiple times that fail amr gives the meaning of dua when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, there's no separate fail for dua. Say, we use the fail amr, but it will give the meaning of dua. So, aj'alni, you make me. Now the question is, you make me what? Mukima. Mukima, you can see clearly the nasab status. You make me what? Mukima, which means that this mukima is also maf'ul. So this was maf'ul number one, and now this mukima is maf'ul number two. But mukima is connected with the as-salata. As-salati. So mukima and as-salati, you can see. So mukima is actually mudaf, and that is why as-salati is in jar status. So instead of saying that mukima is maf'ul number two, now you will say that mukima salata is maful number two, the whole thing. So aj'al fail amr, fail is anta, ni maful number one, muqim as-salati maful number two, and then this waw is ataf. Min zurriyati, min jar, zurriyati majroor, but inside of zurriyati it is actually two things, zurriya and ye, zurriyatan, zurriyatan and ye, two things are connected. So zurriyati itself is a mudaf, mudaf ilay. So even so, min is jar, zurriyati majroor, but zurriyati itself, we need to know this, it is a mudaf, mudaf ilay. Zurriya, zurriya is the mudaf part, and e is the mudaf ilay part. Again, this ya mutakallim, which was supposed to come with the rabbi as well. So now, min zurriyati is a jar majroor, and we know that the role of jar majroor is that it is mutaalliq. And you have to see that which fail came, aj'al. So this jar majroor is mutaalliq bil aj'al. Mutaalliq bil fail. Let's translate it now. Rabbi, oh my Rabb, aj'alni, you make me, muqima, establisher, as-salati, establisher of the prayer. Oh my Rabb, you make me, literally mean establisher of the prayer, wow, and min, from zurriyati, my progeny. And from my progeny. And because this min zurriyati is mutalliq bil aj'al, so it is basically, and also make establishers of prayers from my progeny. So this min zurriyati, this waw is actually connected with this word aj'al. So as the dua, oh Allah, make me and also make from my zurriya. Look at the beauty. It could have been said, wa zurriyati. There's no need to bring the min. But Ibrahim alayhi salam is actually being very careful. He knows that there are going, at least he is having this, you can say, fear that there are going to be some from his zurriya, from the progeny, who will not be the establisher of the prayer. Okay? So that's why this min is giving this meaning that some of my zurriya, not all of them will be the establisher of the prayer. So, O Allah, make me and from my progeny, what? Establisher of the prayer. Now, if you make it like in a proper sense, O Allah, make me and from my progeny, the ones who establish the prayer. Any question about this first part?
Mukima is passive.
No, brother. Mukima is ism.
Mukima.
Mukimun, mukiman, mukimin. It's a ism. Ism does not have any passive or
active. Oh, sorry. It's ism. Fine. Mukima.
Because mukima is mudaf and as-salati mudaf ilay.
Which type of ism it is? It is like ismul fa'il.
Yes, brother. Yes. Ism-fail. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Kama yakumu.
Yeah.
Kama yakumu and then kum.
But normally this mu comes in front of this mazid fi verbs, I think, normally.
Asif, why? Because as you can see that kama is from irregular verb. It has what they call haruf illat.
Okay.
So inshallah, for example, if you go and inshallah, I'll show you in a minute, if you check the sulasi mujarrad family of the irregular verb, then inshallah you can see this pattern there.
Right. Okay. Because we have not done that one, that's why.
Yeah, okay. Exactly. Yeah. Okay, inshallah, this was the first part. Let me erase this one so you can see the next part more clear. Okay. Rabbana, I don't need to tell again. I have told already, it is actually, there's a ya employed here. And because of that ya, this you have the fatha on the rabba. Why? Let me tell you one more time. What is the rule? If your munada is a mudaf ilay, then the mudaf part of munada will go into nasab status. And because Rabbana, which is munada, and because this munada is mudaf ilay, for this reason, mudaf has gone into nasab status. Okay, and there's an employed ya. So basically, this ya is the justification that why Rabb is in nasab status. So, Ya Rabbana, O our Master. Okay. Ya Rabbana, O our Master. Ya is employed, Harfun Nida. Rabbana is Munada. Okay. And then move on. Vow is Ataf. This vow is also vow of Ataf. Takabbal. Can someone tell me that which family is it?
The fa'al.
Excellent. Whenever you see this extra ta and second last letter has tashdeed, this is the clear sign. So anyhow, takabbal is fail amr. It has fail anta. And but this fail amr will give the meaning of dua. Okay. Takabbal, you accept. Dua'i, please pay attention. Once again, this is the sign that there was ya here, and that ya has been removed. Okay, this last ya has been removed, and this kasra has been given. Because if you think of this one, for example, takabbal, you accept what? Dua. So dua should be in nasab status. Why? Because dua is playing the role of maf'ul. You accept what? Dua. Okay, and which means that dua, the actual word was dua. Why? Because it should be in nasab status as a maf'ul. But it was dua plus ye. Dua plus ye. My dua. It is a mudaf ilayh construction. My dua. So that ya has been removed, and this last kasra of the dua is telling you that ya is removed and kasra is given. In reality, the word dua has fatha. Why? Because it was maf'ul. So, Rabbana, O our Master, wa takabbal, you accept dua'i, my dua. O our Master, you accept my dua. Inshallah, clear? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, let me, inshallah, move on to the next part. Once again, Rabbana, same as I said here, everything is same. Okay, this one, Ghafara, Yaghfiru, Ighfir, Fail Amr. It has a built-in file, and that is Anta. And this Li, Jar Majroor, Lam and Yi, Jar Majroor. It will play the role of Muta'allik. So, Rabbana, O our Master, Ighfir, you forgive, Li, for me. You forgive for me. And now you can also say, you forgive me. Because obviously, you don't need to translate literally, but you need to know that li is a jar majroor. Okay. And then this vow is ataf. And then lam is jar, walidi majroor, and walidi. And this ya is for the, let me erase this so you can see it more clearly. So this lam is jar. This lam is jar, Walidi majroor. And this last ya is a attached pronoun. It will play the role of mudaf ilay because pronoun is attached with the ism. Walida. Okay. So wa lam jar. Walidi was majroor, but because walidi and ya are connected, so these two are connected as mudaf mudaf ilay. Now you will say that lam jar walidayya majroor. Walidayya, my parents. O our master, you forgive me and for my parents. So basically, after the vowel, you have another jar majroor. But within the majroor part, it is another mudaf mudaf ilay construction.
So I have a question here, sir. So wali wale di, but here we read the wali wale daya.
Yeah.
So the dal has fatha on it.
Yeah.
So what is the reason? I know it looks like it is related to the pronunciation to make it easier on the tongue. Is that the reason?
That's it.
Okay.
Because of this lam, this was in just. It has kasra, but but just to make it easy on the tongue, this change has been made.
Yeah.
And by the way, this thing is very common in the Quran, that something is changed just to, for this reason, that it should be easy to pronounce.
How come it is valid? So how come it's coming for the parents? It's not just for the, like, walid is not just
okay.
Father.
Okay, if somebody can give this answer, I will be very impressed. Please tell me that if you get the question, please give the answer. Let's test the waters.
Wa has a khara jabar.
Okay, let me make it easy for all of us. Yes.
Is this light?
MashaAllah, it was walidani. Walidani has been made walida. My noon has been removed because you want to use the word as mudaf. So walidani has been made light.
Gotcha.
And walidani literally means two fathers. But it is in the Quran that when it is used as the pair, it means father and mother.
I give you
one more example. When Yusuf alayhi salam asks his parents to sit on the throne, it says that wa rafa'a al-arshi abawayhi, and he asks bo abawayhi. Abawayhi means two fathers. Abawayhi, he asks his two fathers to come on the throne, but it is actually father and mother. So this thing is very common in the Quran, that sometimes the word used is only denoting the father, but it is actually covering the mother as well. I give you one more example. You know, in Suratul Raad, it says that those people who will enter into Jannah, Allah will combine them from their parents, from their children. So it says that وَمِنْ أَبَائِهِمْ وَزُرِّيَاتِهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ. I will combine them and their parents. Now, obviously, Aba means Abamin fathers, okay, but it is covering mother as well, if that makes sense. It is very common phenomenon in the Quran. So anyhow, this word was walidani, and walidani has been made light, and that's why noon has been removed. Inshallah, can you move on, inshallah?
Jazakallah.
Right. Okay, so then again, this waw is ataf. Lil mu'minina, lam is jar, and mu'minina majroor, jar and majroor. It is still mutalliq. Mutalliq bil hu, mutalliq bil this fail. And then yawma yakumul hisab. Yawma, we have discussed this thing multiple times, that any word which give the expression of time or place, it is special mudaf. Special mudaf. So yawma is special mudaf. Whatever will come after this one, that will be mudaf ilay. Now let's see what came after it. Yakumu. Look at this one. Yakumu. It is actually fail mudare. And which number? Number one. Mudare. Number one. It has a built-in huwa. But look at next one. Al-hisabu. Ism has come in rafa status. So al-hisabu will cancel the huwa, and al-hisabu will become the fa'il. So yakumu mean he stands, he stands up. Okay, but now you'll say when the hisab is established. Oh, sorry, yakumu mean he established. He establishes in mudare. He establishes or he will establish, right? But now hisab will replace the word he. When the hisab will establish, the day of establishing of hisab. So which means that this yawma was special mudaf, this whole sentence is mudaf ilay. And which you say, fi mahalli jar. The whole sentence, yakumul hisabi, is fi mahalli jar. So, and the whole thing is connected with this one because of this vow. So let's translate it. Rabbana, O our master, ighfirli, forgive me, wali wali dayya, and forgive my parents, walil mu'minina, and for the believer. When yawma yakumul hisab, the day of establishing of hisab, the day of establishment of hisab. Now, yakumul hisab is not a mudaf mudaf ilay, but it is just a language problem that when we translate it, it looks like mudaf mudaf ilay, but you can see clearly that yawma is special mudaf and yakumul hisab is the whole thing as a jumla in the place of mudaf ilay. And this is basically one jumla. Inshallah, clear this one. I'm expecting one question, but no one is asking that question. I'm expecting one question. I am expecting one question, brothers and sisters. No one is asking that question. I don't know why. Brother Tafazzul. Brother Tafazzul.
Yes, brother.
You have to ask me one question. I'm expecting. In the last part, walil mu'minina yawma yakumul hisab. Brother Chanzeb. Okay, the question should be that why Yawma is in
Nasab?
Why Yawma is in Nasab status? This should be the question, okay? And we know that in Jumlatul Failiya, the whole thing is a Jumlatul Failiya. When you get Ism in Nasab status, that Ism plays the role of Maf'ool, which means that Yawma Yakumul Hisab, the whole thing is actually Maf'ool. And inside of the whole thing, yawma is special mudaf and yakumul hisab is mudaf ilay. This should be the question. That's why yawma is in. Because you know, we have discussed this point that question of when, what, why, where, all of these questions are maf'ool, and that's why yawma was in nasab status.